Hi guys, my name's Rebecca Hidalgo Rains with Grateful Heart TV, and those of you who know me well know that my daughter Hannah is in Hawaii right now. She is safe, and I want to let everybody know that. I've had so many people reach out to me about these Maui fires that have been, you know, happened a week ago, and there's so many people who unfortunately lost their lives, and I'm actually on a call right now going to share with you guys the information how we can help from mainland those that have been affected. As of this morning, I believe the death count's nearly 100 and they're not done counting. So let's see what we can do to help these folks out. Hi, I'm Rebecca Hidalgo Rains, and you're listening to Grateful Heart. I started this show to help educate my clients on the real estate market, and it's evolved into so much more. I've found that I love talking to people and I love learning new things. While our expertise is still on the health of the housing market, we want to focus on the health and the well-being of our listeners as well. More specifically, where we reside in our hearts, in our minds, and in our homes. The biggest purchase in our life just isn't a house. It's where we raise our children, start a new business, pray for our loved ones, and follow our dreams. It's even where we listen to our favorite podcast. When we are successful at home, everything else just falls into place, and we are so grateful for that. Home is where the grateful heart is. Thank you for joining us today. Hi guys, I'm your host, Rebecca Hidalgo Rains with Grateful Heart TV, coming to you from Arizona, but talking to you today about Maui. Oh my goodness, anybody who knows me knows that my daughter, 25-year-old Hannah Banana, she left for school back in 2016, went over to University of Hawaii, got her bachelor's, now has her master's, met a boy, fell in love, and never came back to Arizona. And as a result, I've had so many people messaging me this last week wanting to know if Hannah's okay. So just everybody watching who knows me, Hannah's okay. She's on Big Island. But Maui was not so fortunate. So today I'm bringing to you an emergency quick little episode because I want to be able to help folks over there in Maui with your help. And today I'm bringing on Paul and Jeremy, are my realtor partners out on Oahu. Welcome to the show today, gentlemen. Thank you for coming on.
Hey, yeah, thanks for having us.
Yes.
I'm real excited to be on the show. Thank you so much, Rebecca.
Oh, you're very welcome. Now, a little history behind these two. I haven't had the opportunity to meet Jeremy in person yet, but Paul and I have been working together for months now trying to bring affordable housing, not just to Arizona, not just to Hawaii, to the world. And we plan to use SIPS panels, and we're going to talk about that before we get off the show today. But for today's purposes, we're talking all things Maui. Now, in Maui right now, I just want to share with you guys one of the articles I just pulled this morning. Maui wildfires, as of this morning, talking about the death toll reaching 99 people. I personally was just there last May. I was surfing out in that ocean. And this devastation, it's hard for me to picture how this could happen so quickly where so many people were trapped. And I'm sure Jeremy and Paul probably can speak better to that since they're over there right now. We are going to talk about these dwellings here and some of these different charitable organizations. But first and foremost, one thing I wanted to talk about was this post. As a result of what's going on over there, unfortunately, there's always seems to be individuals who maybe aren't as cognizant like they should be of what's going on in the world. This post here is talking about how there was tourists, you know, surfing and playing in the water, like in the moments that people were literally passing over there. I can't, it just breaks my heart. And I'm sure that's the same for both of you guys, because as a result, I've also been warned that there's some charitable organizations popping up that are not legit. And so we want to make sure that we can give a source to people where they can feel good about where they're sending their money if they choose to help all of these families and people that have been hurt by the Maui fires. Jeremy and Paul, please give me a little bit of background about what you guys are doing over there in Oahu, your background in general, and what we can do today to help people that are wanting to help Maui.
Jeremy, would you like to go first?
Well, yeah, I can just give a little background on myself. So I've been a realtor on Oahu for 10 years now and worked with Paul the whole time. He kind of got me into real estate. And so we've been primarily doing that. Paul's been involved in SIPs for quite a bit longer and charitable organizations. So maybe he can touch a little bit more on that.
Sure. My name is Paul Staples. My wife and I started our real estate company almost 20 years ago now, and Jeremy has been with us at that time. So basically, simultaneously as we were doing professional real estate, we also have a nonprofit called iHealth. Mm-hmm. And it was incubated because of Hurricane Yolanda in the Philippines. So we after going over there, personally sleeping with the people that lost their homes on the grounds of our church over there, and seeing the devastation in their families, it really touched my heart.
Right.
It really touched my heart.
Well, and that's, I know you're emotional about it because it means so much to you, Paul. And I got to visit your home a month ago when I was in Oahu to check out the materials, the SIPS panels that your company, Archipelago 7000, has gotten behind. And it's so amazing material. It's wonderful for hurricanes, it's wonderful for earthquakes, and it's also wonderful for fires. As a testimonial to the material, I got to visit Paul's home, and he literally sat there with a blowtorch on the wall having a conversation with me for a couple minutes, and as he pulled it away, there wasn't even a scorch mark. So I know I'm very excited. I'm personally using this material to build affordable homes, starting here in Arkansas first, also in Arizona. And I can see why, because of the how easy it is to put these homes together with this material, how it could solve an emergency housing crisis that is already happening once they are able to just clear the rubbish that they're dealing with over in Maui right now. Since from my understanding, and you guys can speak to this, how is it possible that so many have perished? Like, what happened? What I heard over here, and you guys probably have better news than we do, that there was some storm that just amplified the winds, and that's why it just did what it did. I'd love more information from you guys, what you're hearing there locally.
Well, I was actually on Maui the week before last. I came back to Oahu Saturday night. I was just there hiking. We went up to Haleakala and hiked. And so Saturday daytime, I made my way out, not quite to Lahaina, but about halfway 15, 20 minutes from Lahaina. Mm-hmm. And the wind on that side is always strong. I think they call Maui the Windy Isle. Mm-hmm. It's one of the best places in the world for kiteboarding, those kind of things, because there's always wind. But this particular day, Tuesday is when it actually happened. Yeah, there was, what was it, Hurricane Dora, I think it was called. Mm-hmm. Anyway, that had strengthened the wind considerably. And so if you see some of the posts from people over there, you can just see the wind whipping. So I don't think anybody knows how the fire actually started. But once it started, that wind just took it through. And being on the west side of the island, just like every island, the west side is the dry side.
Right.
It doesn't get nearly as much rain and water as the other sides. And yeah, when we were out there on Saturday, I mean, it just everything out there was already dry. So it was kind of just, unfortunately, kind of the perfect storm of conditions. And yeah,
so
I don't think anybody would have seen it coming.
I read that, you know, because of the traffic over there. I mean, for those of us who travel over there, we are familiar with it. You know, the roads are not, you know, the normal highways we're accustomed to on mainland. And it sounds like a lot of the cars, you know, they're just traffic jammed and people were forced to run from their vehicles to find safety. And some found it in the ocean and some did not. And that's, you know, what they're working through right now. So we're looking at a full week of this devastation, still not a final count of the lives lost as a result. So what I want to do, I'm going to take a quick commercial break. When we come back from break, we're going to talk about iHelp and the other two charitable organizations that we feel comfortable directing people to if they want to give to Maui and do their part to help. And then I would love to talk a little bit further about your emergency dwellings, your sheds, if you will, that could be utilized if we can, you know, raise the capital and funds to get some over there to Maui to those that need it. So we'll be right back, guys.
If you're looking for a mortgage, you need a personalized plan, not a click button get mortgage option. My team and I have saved families thousands by proactively planning their home purchase or a refinance. Buying a home is a huge decision and it deserves a strategic approach. My team and I provide a comprehensive mortgage plan, including a complete credit analysis outlining the steps needed to improve your credit score and help you qualify for the best rates and terms in the market. Visit us at tkteam.us today. We'll ensure you get the best guidance so you can make the best decisions. The TK Team, moving you forward.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Hidalgo-Raines with Berkshire Hathaway Home Services, and I've been selling homes here in the Valley for over a quarter of a century. I want to say that experience truly matters, so when you're looking for a realtor to help you either buy or sell your biggest purchase of your life, I hope you'll consider using me. My experience doesn't matter near as much as my clients, so I do dare you to Google me, and I promise you'll see nothing but fantastic reviews, because I really do truly care to help navigate you and your family to the very best experience you'll ever have with buying a home.
Have you been thinking about buying a new house or refinancing your existing mortgage? Interest rates are still around historically low levels. Why pay a higher rate when you don't have to? Call Joe Smith, me, at Epic Mortgage LLC, 602-741-4121 for a free mortgage quote or pre-qualification. Epic Mortgage LLC is a locally owned, independent mortgage brokerage that provides low-cost options for its customers. Independently owned means low overhead, so you get the best rates, fees, and service. Keep more of your money. Brokers are better. Realtor recommended for over 20 years? Contact me, Joe Smith, at Epic Mortgage today, 602-741-4121.
Whether purchasing a home or refinancing, we know you have choices when it comes to choosing a title company. Navi Title Agency is the leading source for all title, escrow, and marketing needs. With access to the largest title insurance underwriter, Navi Title facilitates successful closings and protects clients from fraud. Creating solutions that save time and money for everyone, ask your realtor or loan officer today about using Navi Title on your next real estate transaction. Navi Title Agency is locally owned and operated in the state of Arizona.
All right, guys, we're back from commercial break. I know that those commercials were riveting. And everybody right now is just waiting to see which charities we feel comfortable they will not be burned by, because they are, we have, you know, feel comfortable that they are legitimate. Obviously, the first one, Paul, is going to be iHelp. That is part of the nonprofit arm of Archipelago 7000. Let's hear from you about that. And I'm going to just, as you talk, I'm going to scroll over so people can see the website, okay?
Okay, sure. So iHelp, iHelp was started by my wife and I and our two partners, actually four partners, and we came up with the concept about almost 10 years ago when Hurricane Yolanda hit. We were eating dinner and we all just said, hey, let's really do something. So we bought airplane tickets and we kind of went over there after doing some research on SIPs, structural insulated panels, and we gathered information. We flew to different companies and we found out that this SIPs product was perfect for disaster resilient disaster victims.
I'm gonna scroll
because
over
it
as
goes
you're
up
talking.
Like a Lego set.
Yeah, so as you're talking, here's some imagery of the SIPs panels, and they're made out of magnesium oxide, which to me is the fascinating part because it makes it so resilient when it comes to fire. And the dwelling that we see in the middle of this picture that you sent, what are the dimensions on that home? Do you know offhand, Paul?
Yeah, Jeremy, go ahead.
Yeah, that one is actually about 11 by 12.
Okay.
The typical one that would be made for more for legal purposes than anything here is 10 by 12. But yeah, that one's 11 by 12.
So why the difference of the 10 by 12 by 11 by 12? Because I know we talked a little bit before we got on air about the permitting process and you can't have power in these sheds if you need a permit. And the permitting process, it sounds like, is the problem over there in Hawaii right now. And Paul, you're laughing, but it's not a laughing matter, is it not? I'm sure that's probably more out of frustration, you know, the laughing that we're doing right now, because it's like, man, we could do so much good if the permits didn't take, what is it, a year right now?
A year or more.
Why in the world is it taking so long to get permits in Hawaii? And that's something like that has got to be fixed, because I can't imagine with what's going on in Maui that they are not going to be sending in droves of insurance company adjusters for those that were lucky enough to have insurance to rebuild, right? And what a wonderful product your product would be for those that need to rebuild, so they don't have the fear of losing their homes to fire again.
Yes. So I can't speak for the government, of course.
Right.
But I know our government is filed some special proclamations to try to, you know, try to get stuff going a little bit better.
Well, we're only a week into this process right now, right? So, I mean, this just happened in this last week. Hopefully there'll be news coming that will help you guys build more of those 10 by 12. What did you call it, Jeremy, before we got on air?
Well, shed, but, you know, could be used as like a backyard office type thing. Yeah.
And I mistakenly said ADU, and you're like, no, we can't build ADUs because of the permit process. So I think it's your guys' workaround to at least put a roof over people's heads while they're rebuilding them, their own homes, right? And then, so Paul, if somebody wants to get on board and help with this initiative, the website I was just showing was iHelp. It's ihhelp.org, correct?
ihhelp.org, and and that's the website that you can give to people. We got permission from our president to help with Maui, because we, our focus is normally the Philippines,
right?
But this came so fast, this Maui thing came so fast that we want to help them over there.
Okay.
So people can actually donate to our website, and we'll make sure funds get to those victims that really need it.
That really need it. So, all right, I'm going to scroll back over to that website, because I definitely want to talk about that again. So there's the link right there. We'll make sure to post it with all of our social posting. And then there were two other websites that we were given by our colleague, Jim Edmonds, out of Kauai yesterday. You know, everybody in Hawaii that has a heart is trying to do what they can. And I believe this was one of the websites, which was Regenerative Education Centers. And in a response, they are also working on off-grid shelters for, you know, those that need emergency housing. But last but not least, Jim had said that this organization has been around for over 100 years. So if that's the case, I feel pretty good about people checking this website out as well, which is HawaiiCommunityFoundation.org. And so between these three, we'll make sure that as we post the show segment and the fact that my daughter is safe, for those of you guys who know and love me, you know, I am just so grateful and happy to help with whatever way I can. Because this is important stuff, you know, ultimately, you know, we're here to help others. And if that's not in your heart, I hope it will be after watching today's episode. Paul or Jeremy, are there any final thoughts that you would like to impart on anybody listening, watching, any calls to action that we want them to do besides going to your website, Paul?
Sure. If they're really interested in helping, this is just the tip of the iceberg. Mm-hmm. We really want to help victims all over the world, and we've been building this factory in the Philippines just to do that. So if people, you know, this is not a one-time thing for us. We've been working on this with three structural engineers, for almost 10 years now. So we, in a nutshell, we have helped find a solution for the affordable, disaster-resistant housing market.
And it's definitely an emergency need right now in Hawaii. You guys have been solving that need out in the Philippines for quite some time. I know just even emergency restrooms are important, and those are things that you have done to help those in the Philippines and hopefully now in Maui as well. So I want to encourage anybody watching, listening, and wanting to give and help, please check out the different websites we have associated with this show. And for Paul's purposes, again, Paul, what's the plug on your website? iHelp.org?
iHelp.org, yeah. ihhelp.org.
Got it. Mahalo, Paul Staples from Oahu, and your counterpart, Jeremy, for coming on and sharing with us what you're doing over there to help and how we can help over here. And I hope anybody listening hops on your website and helps those folks over in Maui that desperately need it right now. Mahalo.
And so much
love to you guys over there. I hope that we can make a difference together.
Thank you so much, Rebecca.
Thank
you. I really appreciate the opportunity.
Thank you. Have a great day, Paul. Take care. Mahalo.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Guys, I hope that inspired you to hop on the website for Paul Staples. If we can get some housing created for those in Maui that need it right now, it would be so amazing. And regardless whether you want to donate to his website or a couple of the others that we have, whatever you have in your heart and your wallet and you're able to give, I certainly encourage you to give because there's so many people that need it over there right now. Thank you for watching. What a great show, and thank you for joining us on our mutual journey to becoming unharmable and successful in all of our experiences while we're here in this school of life. We hope you enjoyed it. If you watched us on YouTube, please like and subscribe so you don't miss any future episodes. Likewise, if you're catching us on one of our podcast platforms, be sure to follow us so you never miss out on another one of our shows again. Remember that if you ever have a question about real estate or any of the other topics we cover, check us out on the web, www.gratefulheart.tv, for all of our links to connect with us. I'm on vacation every single day because I love my occupation. I'm on vacation every single day, every single day.